Thank you, Frank. With the COVID-19 crisis spreading in Canada and around the world, Ottawa is set to announce a support plan for people, businesses, and provinces. At 9 o'clock this morning in Ottawa, we are expected to hear from Prime Minister Trudeau to reveal a major aid package for Canadians and for the economy. And with more, we're joined by 680 News Parliament Hill reporter Cormac McSweeney joining us via phone this morning from Ottawa. Good morning to you, Cormac.
Good morning.
Okay, what can we expect today? What are you hearing?
Well, these are going to be measures that should be supporting workers who have to go through quarantine and self-isolation, but also helping the healthcare system in general. A senior government source has told me that there will be the supports for workers, and we do know that the Labor Minister was talking yesterday after a cabinet meeting to discuss a coronavirus outbreak. She would not rule out the fact that the government might eliminate the one-week wait period for employment insurance benefits. That would help workers in several different ways. One, people who might not have as good benefits if they have to stay home for 2 weeks, that they won't have to worry about paying the rent or making ends meet during that time, but it also protects other workers in the workplace if they happen to be feeling sick and might have the symptoms of COVID-19. But there are also going to be that there's also going to be that help for the healthcare system in general. The health minister has talked about how the federal government is going to be leading the charge to make sure that provincial governments and local health authorities and hospitals have the supplies they need. There are national stockpiles, of course, that the federal government can dip into to make sure that this crisis is being handled.
Cormac, of course, there are a number of industries that are impacted here, specifically the travel industry right now. Are you hearing about any aid for them?
It's not clear whether we'll get a full sort of economic package that will be specific to industries. This package as a whole is being described as a significant one that will help businesses, but that could be seen as the employment insurance benefits because that's something that industries have been calling for. The finance minister has said that in addressing this crisis, he's not going to wait for a budget, and this will be the first step, according to my government source. This will be the first step of several to try and deal with the economic issues that have popped up of the coronavirus outbreak. There should be more measures that will be on the way to help Canadians and help the economy. But because this is such an evolving situation, it's not clear exactly when those measures will be announced or mm-hmm. what those measures will be. But we are expecting more measures in the budget, which could come later this month. That's what we're expecting anyway. And the finance minister has hinted that he will be making sure that the economy and the impacts of it are mitigated. And he has mentioned that Canada does have the fiscal capacity to deal with this outbreak.
Yeah, that's the big question, if we can. I want to ask you this. We were seeing our latest case here in Ontario, in Sudbury, of a man contracting the virus. We don't know exactly where it stemmed from, but we know he did travel here in Toronto for a number of officials, government officials, who also joined, including Minister of Natural Resources, Seamus O'Regan, Prime Minister, Premier here. Have you heard any word about that when it comes to testing for government officials?
Yeah, so that was a big question of a number of people on Parliament Hill, whether there would be more testing, whether there would be changes to the operations of government as a result. Right now, it's the status quo, recognizing the advice of the public health agency to do testing. But as you point out, that's a big concern. Many government officials were at that conference that this Sudbury patient was at, and the Prime Minister gave a speech there. The Natural Resources Minister tweeted that he's in self-isolation right now after having a pretty bad head cold, and he's being tested for COVID-19, awaiting the results at the moment. So there is a big concern. The Foreign Affairs Minister is somebody who travels quite a bit, and he was asked whether he's changing his travel plans as a result of this outbreak. He said that, they might change things moving forward, such as if he had any scheduled events in Italy or countries that are really being impacted, they likely would avoid those places. But so far, he's not making any major changes to his schedule. But as this develops, as this evolves, and we get situations like this where major conferences are seeing MPs and ministers become affected and have to self-isolate, I wouldn't be surprised if the government starts making changes to its policies moving forward.
All right, Cormac, I always appreciate your time and knowledge and insights. Thank you so much. So stay with Cormac a little bit later on in the day in City News, citynews.ca and City News at 5 and 6. Thank you.